Hello everybody, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and today we will see something interesting. The other day I was asked a question that how can we see spiritual careers, which means that how can we see that the spiritual life of a person becomes very much interlinked with his career, or that itself becomes like his life purpose, and how to see that the spiritual progress and career are linked and they become inseparable. Okay, so there you go. This is one of the charts and it's a very beautiful chart, so I have selected this, and this is the chart of a healer. This person is into healing, different kinds of healing, and this person is extremely spiritual and has achieved great heights in his spiritual life and has progressed very much from his grassroots. And there you go, this is his chart. It's a beautiful chart. So if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, then please go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video below. And before I say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now, whenever we say that spirituality and career are linked, then we need to see multiple things here. First of all, we need to check, is the 10th house and 9th house connected? Okay, so here if you see, this person is a Cancer ascendant. Again, this is the first house, this is not the fourth house. Okay, so this is the 10th house, which is having the sign Aries. So Mars, which is the ruler of the 10th house, has gone to the 9th house. You see Mars is sitting here in the sign of Pisces, so you find one linkage there. And if you see the ruler of the 9th house, which is Jupiter here, Jupiter is sitting in the Lagna itself. It is in the sign of Cancer where it gets exalted. That means that the 9th lord is in exaltation, which shows the person is very, very, very spiritual in nature. Spirituality will automatically come to you. Whichever planet is in the Lagna, that planet shows things which automatically come to you. You don't have to go there. That automatically comes to you. Okay. Now, this Jupiter is also aspecting the 9th house. So, do you see this? The 10th lord is in the 9th house, and the 9th lord is looking back at the 10th lord. Okay, so this is a very, very, very powerful thing. Now, this can be there in the charts of many people, but what is the guarantee that the person will wholeheartedly do some spiritual practices, or the person will wholeheartedly engage in spirituality throughout his life in matters of career also? Okay, so for that we need to check what is the Lagna lord saying. So we see that this is a Cancer ascendant, and the Lagna lord moon is itself situated in the 9th house. So now the career lord is sitting in the 9th house, the lord of Lagna itself is sitting there, and the 9th lord itself is sitting in the Lagna. Okay, so Jupiter is sitting in the sign of moon, and moon is sitting in the sign of Jupiter. This is creating a parivartan yoga, which means the planets are sitting in each other's houses. So parivartan yoga is the strongest form of yoga which is possible, and parivartan yoga shows the results which are there since birth itself. So this person does not have to do anything for this. This is automatically there. Okay, so this is like saying the Lagna and the 9th house are saying we will protect each other. So those things will be very, 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 very prominent in the life of the person. And apart from that, we also need to check other things in the chart. So for example, the Lagna lord moon is in the 9th house, and that is a friendly sign for the moon, so it is extremely strong there, and the person has three natural benefics conjunct in the 9th house. This is a very, very, very powerful phenomenal yoga. You see here, Venus is the ruler of the 4th house. This is sitting in the 9th house. This is creating one of the Raj Yogas. Then Mars is the 10th lord. It is situated in the 9th house. That is another Raj Yoga here. Then the Lagna lord is situated in the 9th house. That also can be considered as a Raj Yoga. Raj Yogas occur when the lords of Kendras are sitting in trines or with the lords of the trines, or the lords of the trines are sitting in the kendras, or they are conjunct with the lords of the kendras, or aspected, or they are in parivartan. Okay, so here you see that the ruler of the three kendra houses, the first, fourth and the tenth, they are under Raj Yoga here in this chart. Fantastic, this is mind-blowing placements. And Jupiter is the natural significator of spirituality. It is also in directional strength. It is known as Digbala. So it is Digbala, which means this planet is very, very strong in the practical life of the person. When the person is dealing with day-to-day activities, it is very strong. And if you also check in this chart, Jupiter has the Mool Trikon sign in the sixth house, because Sagittarius is the Mool Trikon Rashi of Jupiter. So sixth lord is in the Lagna. And because of that, this person is a celibate, he is not married, and he is going on serving the mission of his guru for lifetime, and the person has no materialistic desire. That can also be seen because the planet which shows materialistic desire, Venus, is in exaltation. Okay, now generally they say, oh, if Venus is exalted, then the person is having lots of comforts of car, home, family, wife, husband, or luxuries basically. But that is true. At the same time, you have to understand, exaltation also means the planet is very, very happy. So the person doesn't need anybody to feel happy. The person is very happy himself. Okay, and how does he become happy? By taking to spirituality, which is the ninth house, because Venus is exalted not in the eighth house or the 11th house or the seventh house, it is exalted in the ninth house. Okay, so this is a beautiful placement, this is a fantastic placement. And Venus is also the ruler of the 11th house of gains, network circles, and associations with people. Okay, so that 11th lord is in the ninth house. That shows that your associations, you will only meet people who are spiritual, and because that is exalted, it is showing that great, the people you meet will be very, very great. They'll be they'll do lot of good to you, and they will also be very good. And you see, the fourth lord is also Venus. It is also placed in the ninth house. It is also in exaltation. So that also shows that the mother of the native was very spiritual, and moon is the natural significator of mother. That is why this is also true, because both the fourth lord and moon are in the ninth house. So this is a very fantastic chart. And as we know, second house is the house of family. Yes. So whenever the second or the seventh house, these two houses are associated with malefics, and to some extent sometimes the eighth house also, then it can show that there are challenges in the life of relationships of the person. Okay, or there are challenges, or the person voluntarily decides to abstain from relationships. Okay, so now in this case, the person is voluntarily not mingling with the opposite sex. He decided to stay as a celibate. And you see here, Saturn and Rahu are placed in the second house. Okay, so Saturn and Rahu conjunction can generally show curses in the chart wherever there is a very strong curse. So curse in a way that may not be good for materialistic pursuits. Okay, so the person is not having any family. And you see in this chart, there is another very beautiful placement here. The 10th house has an exalted planet, that too it is in Digbal also. So Sun gets exalted in Aries, and it gets directional strength in the 10th house. So because 10th house is the strongest of the Kendra houses, this sucks a lot of time, energy and influence in the person's life, and the person is always geared towards working in life, helping people. Okay, but what all the person is doing, that the 10th house may not say, that the 10th lord will say. Okay, and the 10th lord is in the 9th house, you see. And here 8th house also represents in-laws, because it is the second from the 7th house of your partner. So here Ketu is there in the 8th house. That shows that there can be issues with the in-laws. And in this case, as you know, he doesn't have any in-laws at all. And the planet Mercury, which is the ruler of the 12th house, And the ruler of the third house, that is debilitated here. It is in the sign of Pisces where it gets debilitated. But because it is with the ruler of, because it is aspected by Jupiter, which is the ruler of this sign, and it is conjunct Venus, which gets exalted in this sign. So because of these two reasons, it is undergoing a special condition known as Nich Bhanga, which means the debility is getting cancelled. Nich means debility, Bhanga means to get nullified. So the debility of Mercury is getting cancelled here. And Venus Mercury Moon conjunction aspected by Jupiter from the Lagna itself, that one exalted Jupiter. This is like the conjunction of all the four natural benefics in the ninth house. Beautiful yoga this is. And there are many other things in the chart. I can go on and on saying. You can see the seventh lord, which shows marriage and relationships. Seventh lord is placed in the second house, and it is in an enemy sign, and it is with a malefic like Rahu also. So because of that, there could have been issues if the person would have married. And as Vishti Larsen had given a seminar on Venus exclusively, so in that he said if the lord of a planet is badly placed from that house itself, then it is, it's like saying that that house is unavailable. So if you go from the seventh house, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so second house is the eighth house from the seventh house. Okay, so the seventh lord is placed eighth to its own house, so that can show that the marriage is not available at times. But that will be there in many cases. But why do people get married? Because they may not have Rahu placed there. Okay, or but for marriage we have to generally see if there is any inclination. Okay, and now we see planet like Moon and Saturn, they are not having any link. Do you see this? I mean, Saturn is not aspecting Moon, and Moon is also not aspecting Saturn. So that shows that the person is not having that feeling that I need to stay with somebody, and he also does not have any planets situated in the seventh house. So that shows that the seventh house will also not be very prominent in his life. So now, empty houses, 11th house, 12th house, 3rd house, 4th house, 5th house of children is empty. All these houses are empty, you see. There's one house which is very, 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 very dominant in his chart, and that is none other than the 9th house. Beautiful this is. And because Mars is also there, it is a natural malefic. The person could have had some struggles with the father. It could have happened. But I don't know about this, so I will not comment. Okay. And yes, now many of you will tell me, oh, this placement is there here, that could have happened, this could have happened. Yes, there are million other things which could have happened, but we are only focusing here on the spiritual aspect of the person. Okay, so basically we checked the Lagna, the connection of the 10th house and the 9th house. 1, 9 and 10, these are very important. And at times, if the person is following celibacy, we also need to take the 6th house. Okay, but you could be married also, then maybe the 7th lord is associated with these houses, 1, 9 and 10. But now here, because the 6th house is associated, since the 6th lord is in Lagna itself, so it is likely that the person follows celibacy. Okay, now some of you will say, oh, that means every Cancer ascendant has the 6th lord in the Lagna. I mean, if any Cancer ascendant has Jupiter exalted, it's like saying the 6th lord is in Lagna, so is it bad for marriage? Well, not necessarily always, because some they may have planets in the 7th house, or their Venus may be in a different situation. Okay, so we need to check the whole chart, and then we need to give the analysis. So this video is not to show about anything related to marriage or celibacy, but it is to show that how the career of a person can become spirituality itself, and spirituality can become the career itself. So it's like interlinkage of both. And ultimately the Lagna lord will decide what is happening. So here the Lagna lord is also involved in this combination of 9 and 10. Yes, Jupiter, Mars, this thing is being supported by Moon itself. So because of that, and coupled with the placement of Sun, which is the natural Atma Karak, and it is in exaltation, it's in Digbala, it is extremely strong. So these factors make the chart extremely strong. Okay, so of course, this, it's very easy to say in this chart, because there are quite clear cut connections and conjunctions like in the ninth house, but every chart will not be like this. Okay, so first, when we are learning astrology, it is essential that we understand the basics. I mean basics in the sense that we understand binary charts first. Binary charts means where charts are very clear. For example, here if you see the Lagna Lord and 10th Lord are in the 9th house, so you can easily say that, oh, the person is likely to do something related to spirituality in general and in matters of his career also, okay? But every chart will not be like this, and that you will gain by experience where what is happening, and you also have to see the dashas and divisional charts and beautiful horoscope this is. All right, so there you go. If you like this video, then click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who is interested to know if they will be into some spiritual career, or if spirituality will be an integral part in their career, okay? And apart from that, that is all I can say. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video below, okay? Until next time, see you. Good luck. Bye bye.